Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to create a flow with inside of Power Automate to send out a customized email to a list of people in a spreadsheet based on certain criteria inside of the spreadsheet. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So here I am on office.com, and what I want to show you here is that I have 5 students and their emails. And what I would like to do is once they get a grade in my class, if they have gotten an A in my class, I would like to automatically send them a custom letter welcoming them to my honor society. And if the student receives an A in my class, I will use their email right here in column B to send out this document out here on my OneDrive, honorsociety.pdf. It looks like this. So how do I go about doing that? One thing that's really important inside of Excel is that your data is in the form of a table. So if you already created a regular spreadsheet that's not in the form of a table, just highlight the data that you want inside of a table, go up to Insert, and go over here to Table, and just hit OK when this screen comes up. And you can tell that a table's been created because the background colors have been changed on here. And one more thing I would like to do is if I come over here and go to Table Design. See this name up here? It says Table 2. That's the default name given to our table when we just created it. But let's change that to something a little more meaningful because we are going to use the name of this table in the future. So I'm going to click here and just call this Students. Okay, so let's create our flow now. Remember, whoever gets an A in here is sent the PDF for the Honor Society. So I'm going to go to office.com and I'm going to open Power Automate. I can do that by just typing in office.com up here in the address bar and then going up here to the app launcher. And Power Automate is showing up here because I've recently used it. But if it's not showing up for you, just click on all apps and scroll down to the P's. And you can see that Power Automate has opened. Now what I'm going to do is go over here to create. And I'm going to scroll up and I'm going to do an instant cloud flow. So if I click on that, I'm going to be asked how I want to start this flow that I'm about to create. In my case, for now, I'm just going to select manually trigger a flow because you might want to update your entire spreadsheet before you go and send off all of your Honor Society invites. So then I'm going to click create. So the first step I want to add to this is opening up my Excel spreadsheet, because that's where the rows are that I want to determine which ones are the A's. So I'm going to go here and click New Step, and I'm going to select Excel Online. And then I'm going to go down here to List Rows Present in a Table. So I'm going to be asked which spreadsheet am I looking at. So if I click this down arrow here for the location, I'm going to select OneDrive for Business. And my document library is going to be OneDrive. And the file, if I click on this folder icon, I can now navigate my OneDrive to the Power Automate custom email file that I just showed you in Excel. And then finally, down here, I will be asked which table inside of that Excel spreadsheet, and I'm going to pick Students because that's the table we just created. And this is where the name of our table becomes important. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So now that I am looking inside of my table, I'm going to go down here and create a new step. And what I want to do once I'm in my table is I want to say if the grade column has an A, then that's the data I want to work with. So I'm going to click New Step, and this is called a condition right here under Control. So I'm going to click Condition, and right here I'm going to choose a value, and I'm going to use dynamic content when I choose this value. And what that is the name of the fields coming from this Excel spreadsheet that I referenced right up here in the step before it. So if I click here, you can see that my dynamic content window automatically appears. And right here, I'm going to be looking for the field grade. And as soon as I put my condition in, I can see that a container has appeared to apply to each. And this is how I'm going to go through my spreadsheet and go to each record that has an A. So I'm just going to leave that container that Power Automate just created and go back to my condition and set it equal to an A. And so once I've done that, I only care about the track of where it says if yes, because if no, I'm not going to do anything. But the if yes track is the one where I want to send an email to that student. So let me show you how we can customize that email. I'm going to add an action. And the first thing I need to do is I need to go out and get the PDF document. And I'm going to do that by typing in OneDrive right here. And I'm going to select OneDrive for Business. And I'm going to need to navigate to OneDrive for two different steps. So this first step is I need to get file metadata. Because my email is going to require an attachment that has the name of the file and also the content. So the file metadata right here is going to get the name of the file for me. So if I click here and go to the folder icon, I can go to root and I'm going to select the Honor Society PDF. And then I'm going to add another action that's very similar. So I'm going to type in OneDrive again, select OneDrive for Business, and this time I'm going to select Get File Content because this will give me the file itself. And again, I will click this folder icon, go to root, and then click Honor Society PDF. I know that sounds redundant, but you will see why I did that in a minute. And so now my final action, I'm going to click Add an Action, and this time I'm going to go to Outlook. And once in Outlook, I'm going to click Send an Email. So now, if I scroll up, I just want you to understand the dynamic content a little bit. I have information I can be getting from this spreadsheet. I have information I can be getting from the file metadata. And I have information I can be getting from the file content. And that's all going to come into play right here. And we're going to use dynamic content to build most of this. So who am I sending this to? If I look back on my spreadsheet, I have an email address here and here for the people who have A's. I changed the two email addresses for the people who got an A because the email addresses I had put in were fake, and we want to be able to test the results of this to make sure those emails are being delivered after we run our flow. And you can see the name of that column is email. And also, look right here with the column student name because we're going to use this one as well. So I'm going to go back to Power Automate. And in the to, I'm going to click here, add dynamic content, and I'm going to select email from the spreadsheet. And then on the subject, I'm going to click in here, and I'm going to say congratulations with a space. And the dynamic content I want here is the student's name. And in the body, I'm just going to say you have been selected to be in the Honors Society. Now if I go to the advanced options, see the attachment name? I'm going to click in there and you can see right here that I can get file content, and that's from the second line we did in the yes condition. But I don't need the file content here, I need the file name, and that's coming from the metadata step, the first step above. So if I continue to scroll down, I can see the name of the file. That's what I want right there. And down here, this is the attachment content. So if I scroll down here, I want just the top where it says file content. And I'm going to scroll down more and hit save. And you can see up here that it's saving. You can also see right here is the name of this flow. And it's a little convoluted, so let's click once on that. And let's call that Send Honors Welcome to Students with A's. And then because I changed that name, I'm going to scroll down and save this one more time. So let's scroll up and look at our flow one more time, and then we'll try running a test on it. So manually trigger a flow just means we are going to start this flow on our time. List the rows in the table. These are the rows coming from our Excel spreadsheet. So once we look in our Excel spreadsheet, we want to see where the grade is equal to an A. We're going to get the name of the PDF here, the content of the PDF here, and this is who we're sending the email to, and the name of the student. So looking back at our spreadsheet right here, we should be getting one email for Sheldon and one email for Raj. So let's go back to our flow, go to test, and hit manually and hit test. And this is just doing a check to make sure that we can connect to all of the connectors that we need inside of our flow. And you can see this green check mark says we are well connected. And so hit continue. And then I'm going to hit run flow. And then I'm going to hit the done button. And here are the results of my flow running. You can see that I've gone through each step of my flow and they've all successfully run with this green check mark right here. So how do we know that this was a success? Well, let's go back to office.com and click on Outlook. And I can see that I got one for Sheldon with the name in there and one for Raj with his name in there. And you can also see that the attachment has been included in both of these emails. So if I click on one, you can see that that is the Honor Society attachment that we initially created. And if I look back at my Excel spreadsheet, I can see that I have two A's and those are the correct student names. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction to some of the wide variety of things that you can do within Power Automate. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks again for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.